In today's episode of the MJYG Wake Up Call, we are doing a tribute to camp. This is the best day of my life.
Alexa, turn off the alarm. Name the usual morning light up. Start the chores and sweep till the floor's all clean. Devo prayer, do laundry and do the dishes. Sweep again and by then it's 11:15. And so I'll do some work via Zoom or live stream. I'll add a few new paintings to my gallery. I'll play guitar and flute and cook in basic. Wonder when will this quarantine end? Then after lunch it's puzzles and darts and baking. Better crochet a little horseplay and chess.
You there, D5!
Archery and ventriloquy, eat some bacon. Then I'll stretch, maybe sketch, take a climb, play some fetch, and then I'll read some books, see if I have time to spare. Then I'll go to Walmart, I just won't breathe the air. And then I'll brush and brush and brush and brush my hair, stuck in the same place I've always been. And I'll keep wondering and wondering and wondering and wondering, when will this quarantine? Quarantine will end, then I finally will get to see all my friends. What is it like out there in the world when this is over? Mother might just
Manamana, 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 manamana.
MJYG, wake up call. I need you up and at 'em, about to check what's up. And crazy stuff can happen, and you can bet that stuff won't be lame with Philip and Blaine.
Hey guys, welcome to another episode of the Wake Up Call.
Good morning, youth group. Good morning, Blaine. Today is a special episode because we're doing something very cool and bringing in another special guest as we have a camp-themed episode. And who better to share a camp-themed episode with than someone who is the very definition of camp? Ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, Phil the Thrill Wagoner. Good morning. How are you today, Phil?
Man, doing great. Good morning.
So let's just start right out of the gate. Everybody loves camp, but what is the camp factor? You know, why does everybody love camp? What is it that makes camp so special?
I've been going to camp since I was 9 years old, and I think just the idea of just Christians spending a week together, you know, away from technology, away from cell phones, away from internet, and just spending a week, you know, with God and with God's people, you know. And I think just there's so many things that are involved in camp, but just, you know, the time you spend in God's word, the time you spend praying, the time you spend singing, and not to mention, you know, all the fun we have. But I don't know, it's just a beautiful thing. It's just so much fun to spend a week with some of your favorite people in the world, you know. You don't get to do that all the time.
I just love camp so much. You get to know everyone so much better, and you really just get to, I don't know, enjoy all the blessings of the church, and it's just awesome.
There are no people like God's people, and there's nothing quite like spending a time, just a week with nothing but God's people. And you take away, like Phil was saying, you take away all the extra stuff and you just kind of strip it all down to you, God, and God's people. And the magic that happens, it's God. You get to see God work and you get to see the way that it changes people just during the course of a little under a week. And it's exhausting, it's crazy, and it's beautiful. And we all love it. Well, hey, I thought it would be fun in this episode as we think about camp and look forward to camp. I thought it would be fun to maybe take you guys behind the scenes and show you some parts of camp or talk about some parts of camp that maybe you know about, but you don't really know about. We're going to do 10 things that you might not know about camp. Quarantine Stampede.
All right, number one, we want to tell you about how clown ball began. Some of the best things in life, I think, happen organically. And this just happened organically. 2007, senior boys swim time. Me and a lot of the high school guys and the intern that summer, who was John Michael Kennedy, unbelievable intern, unbelievable guy. And between us, we just started inventing this game, which would become clown ball. It was just very organic. A guy would say, oh, and we could do this. And okay. And we made the rules as we went along. And it was just great. The original ball had a very unique design and somebody dubbed it clown ball because it had a lot of bright colors and it might have had a clown on it. It was funny because we were, you know, it was a very physical game. There's a lot of football elements, rugby elements. It's very much, very much physical. And yet you're playing with this ridiculous looking ball with all these colors that looks like you'd get at a 5-year-old's birthday party, you know?
Number two is one of my favorite things, and something you may not know is definitely the history of these guys, and that is superstar teams. Not to brag or anything, but I may be one of the most winningest youth interns ever.
So superstar teams began, I first experienced them when I was an intern in high school at my very first youth internship at Southern Hills Church of Christ. And basically I got to experience what you guys experienced. And Jennifer Miller and Andy Miller put these things together where they put everybody on a team. They kept score. You had a team mask. You didn't do mascots. You had a team name. You had all this other stuff. And so that just planted a seed. Like, that was awesome. It was so much fun. And so when I, you know, kind of progressed through, graduated college, started doing youth ministry, and started going to camp and sort of doing my own camps, that was a factor that just kept carrying over. So props to Andy and Jennifer Miller for the great idea on superstar teams. Number three, I want to tell you about the Wheel of Mayhem. The idea for the Wheel of Mayhem happened the week before camp. It came as just a crazy random idea. The year that our theme was mayhem, we'd added the superstar teams, but as we were coming up a week out from camp, it was like, what if we had this element where you had a mascot and then mayhem happened to your team? And so that started this little ball rolling. And then shortly after, a phone call to Albert England was in order and he built the wheel and it just sort of took off from there. And really the way things got on the wheel was whatever I could sneak past Laura that she didn't think was too dangerous. That was what appeared on the wheel, and really nothing's changed. That's pretty much the way it happens to this day. But it's gotten bigger and badder and more explosive every year.
Number four, why is Sing and Be Happy a thing? The first year I went to camp, it was 1988, and I was 9 years old. They had a thing every morning called Sing and Be Happy, and we had these little books, and a lot of the songs that we still sing at Sing and Be Happy are those same songs that I learned as a kid at camp. Miss O'Leary is an old folk song, and Texas A&M, it is their fight song. You'll hear some different marching bands play That's just an old classic American tune. Another fun fact, 2007 was just an amazing year at camp. I divided them into three groups, and I just said casually, let's see which group can go the longest. Everybody got into it. No group wanted to be the first group to quit. And it was just fun. It was this competition that happened. They just kept going. And by the end of it, I was just laughing and I was blowing the siren on the horn, and nobody would stop because nobody wanted to be the group that quit. And they just kept singing. And I think we set a record of maybe 15 minutes. And so when you ask the longest Miss O'Leary's been sung, I think 30 minutes is the longest.
And number five are those crazy yellow things, or people who just graduated recently, and we call them minions at camp.
The minions started really as an idea of, what if we could find a really cool job for our college kids to play at camp? Especially ones that maybe they're not quite ready to be counselors yet, but they still love camp and they still want something to do. And so that's how the minions were born. And it also goes back to when I was a kid in college and I went to camp. I went to Maywood Christian Camp growing up. Some of my greatest memories were being that age at camp and just getting to hang out, kind of keep your own schedule, make your own bedtime, you know. And so that's how the minions started. And I'm really thankful that it did, because those guys are invaluable during the week of camp. Yeah,
they work so hard and they make so many things happen that week. It's awesome.
Number six, Dear Blaine.
Uh-oh!
Everybody loves love notes. Well, unless the notes written about you, you probably don't love it. But I was blessed to go to a lot of different camps. So I tried to take the best things from different places that I went. I grew up going to church camp with Granny White, Church of Christ. And so when I was there, we had a guy. His name's Don Hudson. I think he did love notes, if I remember correctly. And so it was just something that I always thought was funny, or at least, you know, I thought that could be fun to use again sometime. And so that just kind of stuck with me. And 1 year at camp, I busted that out, and it's just kind of kept going ever since. And so,
classic.
Yeah, there you go.
Number seven. Well, let me tell you something you may not know about the late night singing. When I first started going to camp as a child, the older kids would get to stay up a little bit later and sing late night under the stars, you know, in the dark. And no matter where we've gone to camp, Mount Juliet's gone to several different places over the years, we have always had a late night singing. And there's just something beautiful about, you know, ending your day, you know, ending the night surrounded by brothers and sisters in Christ, surrounded by your friends, but with the lights out. If you've ever been part of that, it's a very pure experience where we're all just worshiping God with, you know, one heart and one mind, and just lifting our voices in song. And it's just absolutely, absolutely beautiful.
Number eight is something you may not know about camp, and something we're really not looking forward to this year, and that's that Mr. Greg Coles is not going to be able to be at camp this year. If you've been to our camp before, you know how great a job Mr. Greg does, and it was not an easy decision, but he's just not going to be able to make it this year, unfortunately. And so we hope that you guys get the chance, if you see him at all, hopefully when we're able to see people again, or get his phone number, something, send him a message. Just thank him so much for the years that he's helped us and that he's just been a tremendous encouragement at camp. So
this is the first time Greg has missed camp in 40 years. And
wow.
he spent 25 of those years as the cook in the kitchen.
Wow.
Yeah. Huge thank you to Greg Coles and so many like him, actually, who've given so much of their time and energy, and they do it, you know, because he loves God and he loves young people. And I was heartbroken when I found out Greg was gonna miss this year. We will miss you, Greg. I hope you will come back.
Number nine, one of everybody's favorite camp personalities,
amen,
is David Minton. And did you know that David Minton once directed camp? Probably also, they said a record number of kids sent home from crying that year. But David Minton had some years where he directed camp when he and Terry were members over at Hermitage. And so David is one of the right-hand men for me during the week at camp. He's so capable and hilarious, and everybody loves him. But if you pull back the humor and all that stuff, you guys already know. He's just amazing guy, extremely capable. And when you need something done at camp, you can always lean on Minton to help mm-hmm. and stuff. So appreciate him. And camp wouldn't be the same without him. And the last thing that you might not know about camp, Stampede, here it is.
Okay. The last thing you might not know about camp is the dog tag ceremony. In 2001, there was a new hit show, Survivor, and Andrew Phillips was the intern at Mount Juliet, and he was the youth minister that summer. It was between John Thomas had been the youth minister. I was coming in at the end of the summer, and Andrew Phillips, the theme for camp was Survivor, and I got to visit for a day. It was a great camp, and I believe Andrew Phillips and Doug Perry had the idea to present dog tags. And my first year, 2002, directing camp, between David Shannon and myself, we came up with the name Stratiotes, which is a Greek word that means soldier. And we talk about how we are all soldiers for the Lord. We're trying to train to be soldiers, to be servants for God. And so I talked to Doug Perry. He told me about the dog tags from the previous year. And I said, I think this would be a great, you know, tradition to do every year. I think it's just a great way of recognizing each person, because each person at camp is vital and important and valuable. And that dog tag is a way to remember camp, to remember the people, to remember the lessons.
There you have it. 10 things that you might not know about camp. There's probably a lot more that we could have said, but those are the 10 that we chose. Mm-hmm. Hope you learned something and enjoyed the educational experience. Props to my friend, Phil the Thrill Wagner. There he is. Phil, thanks for joining us today, man. A lot of fun.
Yeah, buddy. This is the best day of my life.
Hey, guys, me again. Just wanted to interrupt to say a quick word of congratulations to Anna Davidson, who won last week's Youth Director Challenge. It gives me great joy to present to you this week's Not on Disney Plus Youth Director segment. Hope you enjoy it.
So do you think Ditta's gonna like the special juice we got her?
I sure hope so.
It worked.
Hey, now that's a happy ending.
I've been hunting. Killed some rabbits. Their fur will make a nice coat come wintertime. Kaylee, give me the guinea pig. I hear they taste like chicken.
I've been churning butter all morning, nonstop. It is hard work.
I have been making canned goods all morning. We have fruits and veggies. Our stockpile's complete now. Don't shut up.
Hey, where's
Where's the last roll of toilet paper?
No guinea pigs or stuffed rabbits were harmed during the making of this video.
Guys enjoyed the show. You may be thinking to yourself, hey, wait a minute, what about Albert England's joke of the day or dating tips with Darian? I need those things, much like I need nachos. Don't worry, those things will be back next week. And there had better be nachos too. Here's Heath Group Huddle. Bye.
Ready, down, put.
Hey guys, this is Addison from Mount Juliet. One verse that means a lot to me is Matthew 6, verse 25. This verse says, therefore I say to you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about the body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? This verse means a lot to me because we may not know what the future holds, but we do know that God will always provide for us. I would like to challenge all of us this week to look for the ways that God has blessed our lives. Thank you guys and have a great rest of your day.